Hi, and welcome to Practical Mechanic. This is how I put my pool pump on a timer, either mechanical, digital, or Wi-Fi. I set mine up with a Wi-Fi-enabled smart plug so I can set up routines, a schedule, and control it from my phone. But here's the problem. The main issue that I ran into with this pool pump is that the plug has a ground fault circuit interrupt, or GFI, on it. You're probably familiar with the GFI outlets you have in your home. These are usually located in wet locations like bathrooms, basements, garages, or outside if you have outdoor outlets. GFIs are great from a safety perspective because they can help protect you from an electric shock. But the issue with a GFI plug is that it doesn't allow you to plug it into a timer. Why is that? The reason is because when the timer shuts off power to the GFI plug, it trips the reset button, and to use the pump again, you have to manually reset it. This defeats the whole purpose of a remote timer. The solution is that you need to somehow place the timer between the pump and the GFI plug. So one way a person could do this is to cut the wire and insert a timer in the middle, but I didn't want to do that. The solution I chose was to replace the GFI plug with a standard plug, and then plug the standard plug into a Wi-Fi smart plug, which then goes into a GFI outlet. It's important that I only use this in a GFI protected outlet so that I'm still getting that ground fault protection. So here's my mandatory disclaimer. Proceed at your own risk. I am not suggesting or implying that you should perform this modification. I can't be held responsible for any damage or injury that may result. Alright, so here's what I did. The first thing I did was unplug the pump cord and removed the GFI plug. I used a Phillips screwdriver and removed the four screws from the plastic cover to expose the wires. There are three wires, black, white, and green. Next, I removed the two Phillips screws holding the cord in place. Then, I loosened the three Phillips screws holding the wires down. The nice thing is, if and when I want to use this GFI plug again, the locations of the three wires are labeled, making reassembly easier. I replaced the GFI plug with this standard one. It's a 15 amp, 125 volt plug. I like this one. I've ordered a couple of these for several things. So if you've never wired a plug before, definitely consult a friend who is an electrician to do this for you. I fed the cord through the base. Then, the green wire, which is the ground, went to the green grounding screw. Then, the white wire went to the silver-colored screw. And the black wire went to the gold-colored screw. I made sure that all of the screws securing the wires were tight. Then, I tightened up the three Phillips screws securing the plug to the housing. And then I installed the retaining pieces on the back, again with two screws. Alright, so that completed the plug replacement. Then, I plugged my Wi-Fi smart plug into a GFI outlet. This is very important. It must go into a GFI outlet to provide the ground fault protection. Alright, so at this point the wiring is done. Now it's time to configure the smart plug. The instructions for this could be different depending on the type of smart plug you have. Generally speaking, you use the app of the manufacturer of your smart plug for the initial setup. I'm using a Globe smart plug, but there are lots out there that do pretty much the same thing. I downloaded the app, then followed the instructions that came with the plug. It's been a little while since I configured this, but I seem to recall pressing and holding the power button on the side of the plug until it started flashing, then telling the app to search for the device. Once it's paired up, use the app to set your on and off schedule. And you can be done at this point. However, I prefer to keep all of my smart home devices configured in a single app, so I use the Amazon Alexa app. You may decide you want to use something else like Google Home or the Apple Home app, which will work similarly. To pair the plug in Alexa, go to Devices and Add Device. The plus sign. If you've already paired it with Smart Life, it may ask for your permission to access it. Otherwise, just tell Alexa to look for it anyway. I renamed the outlet Pool Pump so that I could remember what it does. After that, go to Routines and set up the on-off schedule that you want. A pair of routines that I find pretty handy is to add a routine to turn the pump on at sunrise and another one to turn it off at sunset. I haven't been able to find a single routine to just turn it on for a set number of hours per day, though the Smart Life app may have that. And there you have it. I hope you found this video entertaining. If so, would you subscribe and give it a thumbs up? It really helps me a lot. Anyway, all the best to you this summer.